Jan Weymouth.
I'm Jan Weymouth. I'm not here to defend Destination St. Pete Pier. I'd like to clarify a few things, and I'm hoping that you'll give a chance to the other architects, the other three of us, or the three of us, to perhaps answer some of your extremely serious questions. They're serious questions that you're asking about our, but just to clarify slightly, we already have three traffic lanes at every place where a trolley would stop. We do the simple thing in our design. That's why our design bulges. Our bridge is not straight on the sides. The driveway is straight, and you just there's just a little lay-by for the trolley to stop, which would allow traffic to go through. We could talk about that. The restaurant, I totally respect what Mr. Gonsmart said. He's right. A fine dining restaurant, I do not think makes sense out at the end of a pier, because it's a long way out, and it does require much more service of rubbish, to take the rubbish out, bring supplies in, get something when it's missing. What we showed in our illustrations that you've seen was we imagined something slightly more upscale than Cha-Cha's was, although Cha-Cha was always successful, more in the spirit of maybe the Hangar restaurant or a similar restaurant. And we did work hard on how to supply that, although we wouldn't want supplies to be coming in the daytime. We'd want them to come in as they would in a New York restaurant or in Paris at 5 a.m., 6 a.m., 7 a.m., bring everything in and take the rubbish out, you know, when everyone has left. So I don't think that the service issues that Mr. Gonsmart talked about would need to be serviced out at the pierhead, although you think you should be able to eat out of the pierhead. And that would be true for Albert's project as well. He would have the same service issues for a catering thing. The restoration costs that you worry about, Mr. Connors, you're right. I've done a lot of restoration work. There can be big surprises. One of the kinds of restoration where there are very few surprises, however, are gut jobs. We are really lucky that your studies, the city's studies of the caissons and the steel framework, have shown that they are bloody good. They are strong. We actually save, I don't know whether it's 15% or 20% of the cost of a new building at the pyramid, if we can use those. And I think the surprises have already been, there are four places where the structural study shows that there needs to be some reinforcements, which mean welding some plates. Finally, if I may,
thank you, Ms. Weymouth. Frankly, I feel uncomfortable with one given lead architect defending his concept absent the others. This was not really set up to accommodate this type of dialogue and debate. So, notwithstanding, you've been heard.